I know the objection to overrule. Go ahead, you can do it.
Just describe the condition of the house.
Sure, I apologize. So now the path that was 2 feet wide, 3 feet wide, was now into the house across the living room, which is probably about from where I'm sitting to the jurors' seats. And then there was a small pathway, smaller even, up the stairs and up to the second floor landing.
And to your knowledge, Keith was working on the premises, correct?
That day, he and his brother were. When I brought my brother back to look at the house, Keith and Michael Schaefer were both upstairs on the second floor.
And you know Michael Schaefer to be Keith's brother?
Yes.
May I ask how you know that?
Michael Schaefer also worked for my cousin, Jason Burke.
Also known as
Jack? Jack, yes, Jack.
Doing construction?
Yeah, whatever he does, masonry, construction. Pipework, I'm not sure.
So, you're back in the house with your brother William or Bill. Keith is there with his brother Michael. What are they doing?
Trying to get stuff cleared out of the house. When we got to the top of the second floor landing, to the right is the bathroom, bedroom door up there, linen closet, bedroom door there, and another bedroom door here. And you really couldn't walk in to any of those rooms. You could push the door and sort of squeeze in as one person, but we got up there and it was a crowded landing. And we spoke for a few minutes, walked down the stairs. I said to my brother, we're now able to take a couple of steps into the dining room. I said, that's the kitchen. And then we got out of there.
You said you had a brief conversation.
I introduced my brother. We talked for a few minutes. How's it going? How's everything working out? And that was it.
Were there any comments about any items that were being found or disposed of, or was it just general conversation?
General conversation.
In that conversation, did Keith say that he had located a safe?
No, he did not.
Did you go down to the basement before the contract was signed?
No.
Why not?
Couldn't get there.
The stairs leading to the basement were still cluttered?
Yes.
So after that visit with your brother Bill, did you still decide to go through with the purchase?
Yes.
So, to the best of your recollection of what happened, what did you do?
I'm sorry, I don't understand your question.
Well, you mentioned previously that once you determined that you were going to buy a property, you reached out to your attorney for a contract. Did that happen in this case?
Yes, so after we went inside, we stood outside for 20 minutes or half an hour, and on the back of an envelope went through the numbers about what I thought it would take and what we thought we might be able to sell it for and whether it was worth the risk. And at the end of it, a decision was made to call Lee Levitt and let him do his work.
Now, when you mentioned risk, what do you mean by that? What risk are you talking about?
There are large risks that over the amount of time it could take to rehab a project or do any project, that there are issues with the economy, that there are policy changes, that there are things like that that affect anybody's ability to get a mortgage and buy a house, or the physical risks that by the time we got everything out of there, we could have exposed a massive asbestos problem that could cost $10,000, $20,000, $30,000 to get rid of. It could have been a totally failed foundation, although it seemed okay to me. Oftentimes, once a house starts to breathe again, things change in it. So our assessment was that it looked good to me. As I said, he doesn't have an aptitude for it. He trusts me. We talked about it. And we figured the worst case is here that we unearth this thing and we have to knock it down. And then we build a house and we get our money out of it and we don't do it again.
Okay. At the time that you were discussing this, you did not have a new buyer on the.
No.
So this would be what they call a spec house, or speculative project?
Yes.
And did you have any sense, again, in these early days, as to about how long it was going to take to get it into the shape that you could sell it?
I was hoping 9 months, give or take. 9 months to a year, I'm hoping.
Did that turn out to be realistic?
No, it took longer than that.
So you contacted Lee and you gave him instructions regarding drawing up the contract?
Yes.
Do you recall what the terms of the contract were?
One was that it was cash.
And what is that?
That we're not taking out a mortgage on the property, that we would deliver to the seller cash at closing.
Was there going to be a deposit upon signing the contract?
I think it's usually $1,000, but I don't recall.
Would the fact that there was no mortgage contingency, would that tend to speed up the process between signing the contract and actually passing title?
Yes.
Why?
Mortgage process can take anywhere from 45 days to 60 or 90 days, depending on what can happen in the process.
So, there being no more, there being a cash transaction, what did you anticipate closing day, or the length of time between the contract signing and closing?
To do with a title search, I think even an accelerated title search takes 2 or 3 weeks. So, figure a month, 5, 6 weeks, something like that.
Let me just ask you, based on your experience or in your experience with these types of projects, can you describe in simple terms what is a closing?
In the simplest terms, in the real estate vernacular, it's when a house is, or house or building, is sold to from a seller to a buyer.
And how does that occur? How does that transfer? Are there documents that are exchanged?
The documents are exchanged, contracts are signed, they're reviewed, they're considered, terms are negotiated. And at the end of the day, it's a matter of moving money from one place to another for an asset.
The term closing, is that a specific event that has specific elements where all the parties have to be in the same place at the same time for a closing to occur?
No.
Does a closing have to be a formal transaction? Do attorneys have to be present, if all?
No. No.
Have you attended closings where there are no attorneys, or it's just you dealing with the seller of the property?
Yes.
Yeah. And yes. Can you describe such a closing? What occurred?
Then, depending on the nature of the contract, either papers can be signed. If someone was on their way on a business trip or going away for vacation, they can sign documents and have them delivered to the attorney before they leave. The attorneys will agree on the HUD, and that is all the money that exchanges, all the taxes that get paid, all of the other things. So there's a bottom line of that HUD that will tell ultimately this is how much money you will owe. For example, if somebody pays forward their taxes for a quarter and then you buy the house the first quarter, the first week of that quarter, then they're owed that money back. So the HUD figures all that out. So once that's arrived at and agreed upon by the attorneys, it's just a matter of signing paperwork. Physical presence
so
is required.
In addition to the attorneys, the parties, namely the buyer and the seller, also sign on the HUD?
I believe so.
And then whatever monies are going to change hands, change hands?
Yes.
And typically it's by way of an attorney trust account check?
Yes.
Do you remember signing the contracts between yourself and Lisa Linder in order to purchase 60 to 240 Allen?
I don't remember. signature is on it.
Okay, I'm gonna show you what's previously been marked as one of three.
What about the, Mr. Vega?
I'm assuming that's the contract and the question you're asking. Yeah, that's fine.
All right, Mr. Burke, I'm gonna show you what's been marked as one of three that is now in evidence. Just take a couple minutes to review the whole document.
Yes, it's the contract that I signed.
Okay, just go back to the last page for a second. Does your, do you recognize your signature there?
Yes, I do.
And are you signing as what?
An agent of Burke Development.
Okay, and is there a signature from Lisa Linder?
Yes, there is.
And is she signing as herself or is she signing in any other capacity?
It just says Lisa Linder, I'm assuming that's yourself.
Okay. Are there dates alongside those signatures?
February 28th of 2013.
For both?
For both, yes.
Okay. If I had asked you earlier in connection with this particular transaction, did you know how, what Lisa's relationship to the property was? Did you know?
It was her mother's, that's what I heard, and it was passed on to her. After her death.
So this was by way of someone passing away and a family member disposing of the property?
Yes.
So I just want to go through a couple of the terms. First of all, is this document was prepared by Lee Levitt?
Yes.
It's a pre-printed form?
It appears that way, yes.
Was it, to your knowledge, was it customized for this particular transaction?
Not to my knowledge.
Is it fair to say it's a boilerplate real estate contract?
Yes.
Or a simple transaction?
Yes.
So, I'm going to direct your attention to the purchase price section. All right, and there's a number that's printed, and then that's crossed out, and another number, and here's the house initials alongside.
Those are my initials, JB.
Okay, and what's the number that was printed?
34,000.
The number that was printed?
Oh, printed, started out at 33,000, crossed out, and handwritten underneath at 34,000.
And how and when and why did that occur?
I don't recall. Might have been a decision that my brother made and told Lee. I asked him, is that correct? And he said, yes.
If he doesn't recall, then that's the answer.
It's a statement.
And then in this particular transaction, was there going to be a deposit at the signing of the contract?
It says there was supposed to have been, I'm assuming, but I don't see where that's marked, what the amount would be.
Okay, do you remember having any specific discussion with Ms. Linder regarding a deposit that signed?
No.
Did she ask for one?
Not that I recall.
Do you recall discussing it with her at all?
No.
Do you recall who her attorney was?
It was Lee Levitt.
And why was that, since he was already representing you? How did he come to represent her as well?
I'm not really sure. I'm not sure she knew an attorney. So.
Judge, I object. That's his answer. I'm not really sure.
Stay.
Do you remember having any conversations with her about it?
No.
So, according to the contract, the amount that was going to be delivered at closing was the entire purchase price?
Yes.
Why don't you take a look at the rest of the body of the document?
Mm-hmm. had an oil tank suite, that was going to be it.
Was that mentioned in there anywhere?
The oil tank?
Yeah.